Let's start with Tyler. Tyler the Creator. Yeah. He had a good interview. What I thought was a great interview.
What he said.
Hot 97 with Ebro and Rosenberg, and it actually made me more of a fan than I already was. I've become a huge fan of this guy, but I'm really a fan of him now after sitting down and watching some of the things that he talked about. And you know, we had a conversation about what were some of the things that, you know, we took from the interview, those that watched it. And I think for me, one of the main things, because I know he said something that Lone said verbatim, by the way, we can get to that. He said it when it happened, what, 3 years ago? Two years ago?
Remember. Whenever they were battling for the number one spot, him and Khaled.
But one of the big things I took from this interview was the fact that this kid actually cares about his music and the product and the level of music that he puts out. You know what I'm saying? Like, he kept saying, I care, I care, I care. And he talked about, you know, being inspired by how Jada rock. We're going to talk about Jada in the verses later on, but the fact that Jada was out there, you know, getting busy and doing what he do for a live performance. And to me, outside of the, even if you want to say the upper echelon artists or not, whatever, however you want to say it, you don't see too many artists on any level at this point just come out and say how much they really care about their product and how much they put into it, and it matters what they release. That doesn't happen too often, especially in today's era where everything is so microwave. Get it, put it out, get it, put it out. Multiple projects throughout the year, microwave. Everything's microwave. So the fact that this kid really takes pride in what he puts out, that's one of the things that jumped out to me that I really liked from this interview and left me thinking, I like that guy. You know what I'm saying? Like, Jay Moore, what was something that you took away from his interview? Because, you know, I think you said it was good as well.
You know, because I've heard him be interviewed before. He's one of my favorite interviews.
Yeah.
Along with probably Vince Staples. You know, I just like to hear these guys talk.
Webby.
What?
I like Webby. I'm sorry. Webby, too. Go ahead.
I'm Tari.
Okay.
Don't do that.
One of the things that really stuck out to me because is when he said, look, in 2005 or six, I'm 14 years old.
Yeah.
And that was a weird time in hip hop because you had Wayne and then like 50. But then like I remember it was like also Laffy Taffy.
Snap music.
And I can just imagine what he, you know, and he's talked about how he felt about the music at that time. And he had been raised on these all these things because he's an actual head. That's what is also encouraging. Because like he knows hip hop, but I remember how I felt at that time. I think, is this hip hop thing something I still want to really be around? I just felt disillusioned. You know, I remember, you know, I had a friend who was a program director, and he had to take out like Common's, not Go, it was The Corner.
Yeah.
And he had to take.
Love that record.
He had to give The Corner spot to Laffy Taffy. And I was like, if this is where the culture is going, maybe I have outgrown this. Right. You know, gladly, you know, it made some better turns in the next few months, but like, you know, sometimes you can be disillusioned with this hip hop thing because
moment music.
Yeah, well, yeah. You know, but in
well said.
You know, you have someone like Tyler who I actually think cares about pushing the envelope but not just doing stuff to do stuff. You know, he actually cares about making an artistic statement and something that people are going to be like, remember when that Tyler album came out 10 mm-hmm. years ago and where you were and what was going on? And, you know, he's one of the, you know, and he's 30 now. And I still, you know, because where I am, I'm still thinking that's one of the younger cats, but he's 30.
Yeah, he almost an old head at this point.
Yeah. And so, you know, when I listen to his music, okay, I see what he's doing there. I see where he's coming from with this, you know, because I had to get over, you know, when Odd Future was first introduced, I was like, I don't Earl's the sweatshirt and you know I just wasn't here
you
for
weren't quite ready to
you know
it was John Blaze man
yeah you know once, you sometimes you know but
it was
some,
John Blaze
you know so, sometimes you know just the names of stuff will just be like I'm not doing this today. Like when I first heard Nipsey Hussle, I'm like, I'm not doing this today. When the first time I heard Jay Electronica, I was like, I don't even like electronica music. You know what I'm saying? Like, those are the things that go through my head, you know? But, you know, I gave it a shot. And I was like, okay, this is good. I see where these kids are going, especially this kid, Tyler. And, you know, everything is relative. It's like when we talked about, you know, what's classic is relative.
Yeah.
You know, because he, you know, like he said, like, look, man, when we came out and they kept talking about the Gravediggers, it was like, I'm from Los Angeles and I'm, you know, I'm this age. I have no idea who the Gravediggers are. Don't not, you know, you're talking about that as something that's classic. I have no idea what you're talking about.
I give him peas too for saying that he did go back and research the Gravediggers.
Yeah, but
after the fact.
But at the same time, he's like, you know, when he said the thing about like, okay, I'm at show and tell. I have this thing that I think is really fantastic.
Yeah.
Check it out. But you keep telling me about what somebody brought to show and tell 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And I was like, I, you know, not that I don't care, but like, can't you just appreciate what I brought to show and tell?
Right.
I'm not mad at that. Lone, what did you, what'd you take from it other than, you know, the fact that you, what he said about Cal was verbatim, that you, what you said.
No, I think it just further cemented the fact that Tyler's just one of my favorite artists. People, personalities. Okay.
What
general.
Did he say, by the way, in reference to?
He essentially said that Khaled so wrapped his entire ego and it's his persona around winning. So when he didn't win, it just he had nowhere to go with it.
Mm-hmm.
It's just literally what I said.
Checkmate.
So, but, and just the way that he conducted himself when he expressed it, like it was like, yeah, I mean, like. That part of the Tyler interview was just like, ooh.
And he kept saying,
it was like, okay.
And he kept saying, and he had everybody like he, talking about
his
track
list. Like, he owned him in the most serious, nonchalant, chill way possible. Like, he destroyed Khaled without even trying.
What's funny is he dropped another album at around the same time Khaled dropped an album. And I guarantee you that Tyler's is faring better than his.
But see, to Lone's point, Khaled got what he wanted.
Yeah,
this previous album was a number one. He don't care about. I don't think he even monitors how it does after that. If the records are still performing, I don't think he care about none of that. It's a number one. I can scream "We the best" and be on Snapchat in my pool saying I work so hard for this. Yeah. And like that's it. Like that's the extent of his album.
That's what he's in it for.
There you go. Exactly. Yeah.
Go ahead, Lone. I'm sorry.
No, but I mean that's just what I took away from it. I mean the whole interview was great. You know, like I just. Like I said, like just listening to Tyler talk and the way that he expresses things and the way that he thinks everything through, I just appreciate, you know, just from one creative person to another creative person. I just appreciate him, you know, and the enthusiasm that he has around writing and growing as a musician is really cool to see, you know, him talking about chord structures and stuff like that.
That's what jumped out to me. Yep.
You know, all that stuff is cool. It's cool to see him like grow from what he was in his first three or four projects to his last three, which were all very musical, and they've kind of continually gotten better as far as the musical, just how the music is progressing throughout everything. Sure. Yeah, just the whole package of everything. It's more than just a hip hop project. It's a musical experience, and I can appreciate that. But again. Outside of all of it, and this is a good lesson to any artist in general, like Tyler is extremely likable.
He is.
And, you know, like no matter what Tyler does, I appreciate his honesty. I appreciate how he speaks from a grounded, just seriousness, confidence level of what he is.
Yeah.
And
he's
you know,
very confident in his ability. But, I love that.
And it's not even confident from an egotistical standpoint. It's just confidence.
Yeah.
And there's a difference in that. So I like Tyler, man.
I'm a fan, man.
So
yeah.
Jay, if you didn't see, it sounds like you didn't see the interview, but based off what we've said, is that pretty much a fair assessment from what you would know from Tyler? Like, are there certain things that you like about him that maybe we didn't mention, or do you echo pretty much what we talked about so far from him?
I mean, I agree with what you all said, even without seeing the interview.
Okay.
The thing with Tyler, for him to even come out and name himself Tyler, the creator.
Yeah.
Like to be young as he was, to have that going through his brain, like I'm gonna name myself Tyler the creator.
Yeah.
And how that name has
evolved.
And I mean, I think we talked about this before as far as artists are concerned. I guess you could say he's more popular of a hip hop artist than Childish Gambino.
I would say so.
But they're kind of one and the same as far as their creative aspects.
It's not limited.
Yeah, it's not limited. Pretty much the ceiling is broken. Glass ceiling is broke. They're to the moon, to the stars, all that good stuff. But
yeah.
I just love the fact that, like you said, he stays true to himself. When he's making these albums, he's literally thinking about how am I going to perform this and tour with this and keep in character with this album. Like it's not like I'm just showing up. Like a lot of people just show up and rap their songs and have a whole bunch of people on stage and that's that. Whereas if you're going to see Tyler the Creator or someone like him, you're going to actually get a show and you'll be happy that you spent that bread, however much it was, to actually see a show.
Yeah.
Because like you said, he talks about how he really cares about what he's putting out there.
Yeah.
And that's important. Those are the type of artists that are going to continue to be out here for years and years beyond. Cause like we've stated that hip hop is a young man's game, but it doesn't have to be.
Yeah.
We are pretty much products of that. I've known about hip hop my whole life pretty much. And I don't really see any time that I'm not going to be a part of hip hop. I may listen to other genres a little more here and there, but that doesn't mean that I'm not going to go back to my roots or whatnot. And I do appreciate Tyler being a type of individual he is and, you know, giving people their flowers as for musically and Flower not boy. Being the type of person that says, well, I've never listened to that artist or I only listened to him for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Well, like somebody that really does music. And if somebody tells them that this person is great, you're going to give them more than 10 minutes of your time.
Great.
Well, you know, one of the crazy things about Tyler, and this is what is so much lacking in, I think, the image of modern music is, he's completely comfortable in his own skin.
Yeah. 100%.
You know, when he said that thing about just from my perspective, Rolex is a whack.
Yeah.
But you know what? If you like Rolexes, you're not wrong either. That's cool.
Yeah. That's dope.
And because that's what I think there's so many. I won't just put it on hip hop. I think there's just so many artists who get into the entertainment business and they feel like they have to put on a costume or they have to put on or, you know, they can't really be themselves.
Yeah.
You know, they got to leave. If they can't tell you that they like something he talked about how he loved the Vivian Greene Emotional Roller Coaster album.
That album was
I would have never expected that from him, you know, because, you know, I mean, once again, he said he's just now turning 30. You know, there are people I talk to my age who don't even remember when that album was out. You know, I remember because I used to play it on the radio all the time, you know, but it's a thing. And I say this about, you know, and I told him this before, is like, you know, our homie Oreo Jones. I said, like, the thing that makes Oreo dope is he is so comfortable in who he is.
Right.
He doesn't.
That goes a long way.
He's not trying to do anything else but be himself through his art.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's what's very hard to do because, you know, there's people who's like, okay, now you got to wear these boots and you got to have this right watch and we're going to get you a stylist and okay, and this is who we're going to market to today. Tyler's just like, okay, this is who I am. And I'm going to perform these songs. Either you're going to like them or you're not. I'm going to go out and say these interviews and I'm not going to, you know, worry about the PR blowback, you know. And he said, like, look, we might not have been able to do the stuff we did if we came out today.
Nah, for sure.
Yeah, I agree.
But he's like, you know, so maybe he's the last of a dying breed of artists who can be that honest and be that.
Well, he was allowed to grow too.
Yeah.
True. Yeah. But like, they don't let anybody, like,
we talked about the baby last week. You know?
Yeah, they don't let people grow now. Like I said, they don't want to see you get better.
I mean, but
they want you out of here.
Tyler talked about how he was one of the first artists to get like canceled.
Yeah,
like he talked countries. About that. Yeah, like he literally was like, man, I was one of the first people in hip hop to actually get canceled.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, and that's just, I'm saying that in relation to you guys talking about his growth as an artist. Like, fam has been through a lot from those first days up until now, but. I was talking to someone about his interview and one of my guys was like, he was like, man, I don't know, man. I like his swag, but I don't know if he necessarily has the catalog. I'm like, I don't think you've really listened to his catalog.
Do
if you
listen,
say that
or just skim through it.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, I don't think you really listened to his catalog. If you can say that fast,
you know what, like, though, it also back to Tyler's own point. It depends where you're coming from. Right. If you're listening and you're hoping for a specific type of rap album or something like that, maybe that's the case.
Okay.
I think we all sitting at this in this room listen to Tyler from a creative standpoint.
Yeah.
Knowing that the next album he may drop may be straight rap, or maybe it's highly musical, or maybe it's a fusion of both.
He might be singing and harmonizing,
or he might be a character the whole
exactly. But we know that he's going to be him in it, you know, like,
and it's not going to be a reach to your point. It's going to be authentic, whatever
it's going to be him. Yeah. So
I think it's cool that he does that, because that further cements him as an artist. Because when you think about artists like Prince and Michael Jackson and Elton John and David Bowie, if you look at like their albums, they literally were evolving every album. They were pretty much different characters.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They were the same person, but different characters to kind of match the mood music that they were in.
Mm. Yeah. Shout out to Tyler, man. I was very impressed. Watched the whole interview. The interview did not lose my attention the entire time.
The best interview I've seen all year.
If you've enjoyed this segment of the New Old Heads podcast, make sure you join our live show every Tuesday from 9 to 11 p.m. Eastern on twitch.tv/newoldheads. You can also catch playback of all of our shows on any podcast app and youtube.com/newoldheadsnetwork. And go to newoldheads.com/community to join our Discord.